Hello and welcome to this quick overview of the Distribution Board Designer. I will show you how to do a board design project with your current boards in your library and create a blank project to show you some quick tips to get you going. First, let's open up the new Distribution Designer by going to Tools, Distribution Boards. When this is open, you'll be prompted with the Open Library item, which should have a lot of your boards in there and your collection of boards. And I'm going to select Stage Boards, for example, and click on OK. The next selection will be asking, basically, which board do I want to connect to the main supply? In this case, I'm going to click on SB1, and I'm going to click Select, and that's going to populate into here, so as you can see. Now, if I just scroll up a little bit, you'll see all the other boards as well that I can connect to this design when I wish. And I'm going to show you how to do that. So, for example, if I go to this DB stage here, if I right-click on that, and I go to supply board, I can go to DB stage and it will connect to it. So that's how you connect your boards together. Now what I can also do is I can also right click on another board, for example, and I can go to supply new board. Now if I do that, it will just be a blank board in here. Now a better way of doing this, and I'm going to just show you how to remove that board now, I'm going to right click and go remove board from system, is you could use your tools in the right hand side. So for example, if I knew it was going to be a four-way board, I could just drag that right over to DB Kitchen Lighting DB and it will populate it there. And then I can start thinking about filling in those circuits. So what I can do to fill in those circuits is I can just double click on that board and it's going to populate my little circuits. So what I can do now is if I go into description, I can type in a circuit and I can fill in that circuit like you normally would. Once that circuit is filled in, you can do some other things too. So you'll notice that I could actually add another single circuit if I wanted to, or I could have used the wizard if I wanted to from here too. But I can also remove circuits, I can remove all my circuits, and I can also reorder circuits. So if I click on reorder circuits, I then have the ability to be able to reorder some circuits by just dragging and dropping and moving those circuits. Once you're happy with your circuits on that particular board, just click OK and then you will see them in here. Okay, so that's really how you can use your current boards in the board designer. What we're going to do now is we're going to create a blank project and go through some of the other settings that are up here. So what I could do is I could save this project by either just going on to new project and it'll prompt me to save this one and I can say yes and the project would have been saved. I click OK and now I've got my new project. So the first thing that I might do with this new project is give it a name. And what I can do is I can go up to project properties up here and give it a name. So I'm just going to put in my first project. And I'm going to click OK. And that's going to populate that title up here. Now the next thing I need to do is supply a new board to the main supply. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select a board here, so six-way board for example, I'm going to drag and drop it and put it on the supply, and that supply is now supplying that particular board. And again, I can go into here and start creating my circuits. So if I double click on it, I can go into my circuits, and I am just going to create one called test circuit, for example. So once you're happy with your circuit you've done, just click on OK and that's going to populate in here. Now what I want to do is I want to create another board so I can show you how that links to a different board as well. So again, I might go to a 8-way board and I highlight on the test circuit and that's going to populate in here and that's going to connect really nicely to that second board. You'll notice I've got quite a nice curved line here, but if you prefer, you can use this and it will just, you use this little option up the top here, circuit style, and you can change it to be less curvy. What you can also do is you can only show supplying circuits as well by clicking on supplying circuits. That will just show you the supplying circuits. What you've also got is show project title. If you don't want to show that project title, you can turn that off and back on again. So that is really how you can create a new project. Now what you'll also notice is that you have your cert tools in the top right hand side. And that's just giving you some things that you can add to it. So types of wiring, you'd be able to add in here. Protective devices as well, you'll be able to add devices. And you'll also be able to add reference methods from here too. Okay, so let's have a look at some other things that we can do as well here. So you'll notice there is a find button. This is cracking if you just want to quickly find a circuit that is within your design. So if I start typing in test, that's going to find it and it will highlight it in blue here. So you can see that that's working in there. So if I can delete that and then that's gone away, you'll see that the blue highlight has disappeared. Now, the next thing that I might want to do is print this particular design out as well. So to print the design, if I click on print and I go current view, I'm now going to be able to print this design. And you'll see that there is a label at the top saying my first project. It's got the details of that project. And then I can just click on print and print it. You can also create a PDF of that project as well. Okay, there is also this view as well. If you do this, it will just give you a different angle of looking at it. It will tell you how many waves are on the board, how many spares, how many and how many single phases, three phases, etc. It's just a different way of how the design, you might prefer it that way if you prefer. But if I click on view again, I'm going to go back to how I like it. Okay, so the other things to just be aware of, if you want to remove or supply a new board from another one, you can do it this way as well. You can supply a new board, but that will just mean it's a blank board. You'd have to go into there, you go into your circuits, and then you might use the wizard at this stage. So you can go into add circuits using wizard, choose your phases. So I'll do three, number of circuits 10, press OK, and that's going to populate them in for me. So it's just another way of creating a board. Okay, that's really it for the distribution board designer. Thank you very much for listening.